Hello viewers, very good morning to all of you. Honorable principal of the college, coordinator of the study center, very respectable academic counselors, media representatives, both from electronic media and print media, my colleagues from Odisha State Open University, and dear learners. Let me at the outset welcome all of you to the first session of the academic year, which is called the induction meeting for the freshers. It's a very unique occasion because it is your first interactive session where you are coming across the study center, the study center functionaries including the coordinator, the academic counselors, the faculty and staff of the university, and moreover you are also coming across the fellow learners. We call it an induction meeting because our intention is to induct you, to orient you, to train you to the basic features of open and distance learning system or an open university system. All of you have come from a traditional system where you have studied either in a college or a university as a regular student. But here, you have joined Odisha Open University as a part-time student. I call you as a part-time student because you will not be attending classes from Monday to Saturday. Rather, you will be called for counseling sessions on Sundays and holidays. And rest of the days in a week, you are required or you are supposed to do your normal routine work as a student, as a housewife, as an employee, or as a self-employed person. So learning here is a part-time work for you. Now, to supplement your learning, to motivate you, to help you, to support you, we have made provision of providing academic facilities through the study center. So hence the study center has called you. You have been attached to a study center. The study center has called you for this induction meeting or the introductory meeting. And after this meeting, your counseling classes will start. So my duty here is to tell you what are the things that you must know, you must learn, other than your basic teaching as a distant learner. Please note that the university will provide you self-instructional material. Unlike other universities where a syllabus will be provided to you, Odisha State Open University will give you self-instructional material. These are neither reference books nor textbooks. These are small blocks pertaining to each course within a program, and within each block you will find small units of 3000 words and not more than 4000 or 4500 words. So you will be provided with complete set of study material, and this study material are called teacher in print. You will hardly require the support of a teacher if you seriously go through the study material. All the study material are either in the process of being dispatched to the learners or are in the printing press so that it will be printed and dispatched to you. I assure you that all of you will be receiving your study material by mid-September to end September. So please bear with us, but please also note that all these study material which I call as self-instructional materials, are already uploaded on the university website. If you go to the university website, in the home page, on the right hand side you will find e-gyanagar, which is a repository or a collection of e-content or e-books. So please go to the e-gyanagar and see or browse the study material pertaining to your program of study. You can browse this study material either through your mobile, if it is a smart mobile phone, or you can also use the web portal in your laptop or desktop and refer to the study material which are available on the Orissa State official website www.osou.ac.in. So my request to all of you is, don't lose patience till the study material have not reached you through post. Please go to the website through your mobile or through the laptop and desktop and refer to the study material. Meanwhile, I'll request all the coordinators to please start the counseling sessions. That is the first point that I wanted to highlight here. I also want to tell you that you have all received a letter confirming your admission to the program in which you have applied. That means we have received your fee, we have verified your documents, and your admission has now been confirmed. And in the admission letter, we have given you an enrollment number. And we have also mentioned the study center to which you are attached. So please quote that enrollment number in all correspondence with the university. You must remember, like the way you remember your own mobile number, please remember the enrollment number assigned to you by the university till you complete the program. Because if you write a wrong enrollment number, either in your assignment or in the examination, many of the services which the university has promised to give you will be denied because your results will be held up. So first thing is, please remember your enrollment number and quote your enrollment number in any communication, whether through email or through telephone. If you are communicating with the university, please quote your correct enrollment number. We have also given you a digital identity card. Now that digital identity card, you take a printout of the digital identity card, laminate it, and come with your digital identity card to the study center or the headquarter or regional center for any kind of sub-service. Without your valid identity card, I'm sorry, the college may not allow you to enter into the premises, because every college has its own discipline, its own rules, its own regulations. So when you are entering into a study center which is normally located in a plus 3 college or a university campus, please follow the rules and regulations of the host institution. The third thing that I want to advise you is that the counseling sessions are very important for you. Those study material are self-instructional, but if you come to the counseling sessions on Sundays and holidays, you will be interacting with very experienced teachers, and all your doubts pertaining to that study material or block will be cleared, will be clarified by the approved academic counselors who are there on a holiday to attend to your request. You will not only be interacting with a counselor, you will also get an opportunity to interact with other learners who have got enrolled in the same program, so that you can exchange your views, you can exchange your ideas with fellow learners, and you can motivate each other, you can inspire each other. So my advice to you is that attend all counseling sessions, but come prepared for the counseling, whether it is an e-content or a self-instructional material in a printed form. Please go through this printed material or e-content and come prepared, so that you can ask questions, you can enter into discussion with your counselors and other learners, and make your presence effective and your learning meaningful. Please follow the university academic calendar. As far as submission of assignment dates are concerned and submission of examination form dates are concerned and dates for the conduct of examinations are concerned, these three things will be strictly followed as per the academic calendar. So have a look at the academic calendar. Go to the website of the university on a regular basis and collect all the latest information about the university. All of you know that university has a mobile app which is called OSOU mobile app, which is freely available in the Google Play Store. Please download that mobile app, because that will be extremely useful to you. If you have a smartphone with internet connectivity, you can download this study material wherever you are. You can download the videos related to your programs. You can get latest notification on important messages that we want to communicate to you. We will also send you SMS reminding you about the date of submission of assignment and date of conduct of examination and submission of your examination forms and declaration of results, or any other seminars, workshops that we are planning to conduct. You will get instant messages through SMS through the mobile app. And moreover, you can interact with the university by giving your feedback, either on counseling or on assignment evaluation or on the project guidance and supervision on your project, about your result, about your evaluation, everything. Go to the feedback, and there is a student feedback, there is a counselor feedback, and within student feedback there is feedback on counseling, feedback on assignment evaluation, feedback on project, feedback on examination, feedback on results, feedback on study material, feedback on assignment. So you can immediately click it and give your feedback. In 2 minutes your message will be communicated to the university and particularly to me, and I assure you that I constantly go through the feedback of the students, and policy decisions are made based on the feedback that the students are giving to us through the mobile app or through the web portal of the university. So please don't forget to give feedback to the university. Also, please note that there are many technologies which are at your disposal. If you want to really take benefit, go to our interactive website on a regular basis. You will find that every day new things are uploaded, new study material are uploaded, new videos are uploaded on the website, and you will have an opportunity to see these videos, watch these videos, read the e-content and learn many things. There is a C Delta program, which is an online program, free of cost, add-on program given to all the students, free, absolutely free. I advise you to register for that program. Go to the homepage of the Odisha State Open University, click on C Delta and register yourself. You will get, after completion of this online program, which is a modular small program, you will get a digital certificate of completion of the program from the president and the chief executive officer of the Commonwealth of Learning, and it will add value to the degree that you are earning. And when you get a certificate or a mark sheet or a grade card from Odisha State Open University, the successful completion of C Delta program will also be reflected in your grade card. So these are value addition to the degrees that you are earning from Odisha Open University. And I request you to take full advantage, full use of these facilities. I also request you to have other facilities like e-library. There is an e-library, and in the letter confirming your admission, I have given you the user ID and the password. So please go to the e-library. You will get lakhs and lakhs of books. You can choose any book that you want to like and pertaining to your area of interest. So hardly any university gives access to the student to refer to journals, periodicals, theses, magazines, newspapers from across the globe through the e-library. So take full advantage of the e-library that the university is planning or intending to provide to you. And finally, I would like to tell you some very interesting statistics about this year's admission. Friends, I am very happy to tell you that this year's admission has crossed 11,000 compared to say 4,500 last year. So there is an increase of almost 7,000 students this year, which shows that how Odisha State Open University is gradually becoming popular among the learners in every part of Odisha. And in the days to come, in the years to come, I am very sure that more and more students will be choosing Odisha State Open University and its distance education method and its technology enabled learning as the method for having higher qualifications. I am also sharing with you that maximum number of students have taken admission in master degree program. And these master degree programs, be it in political science or Odia or English, history, MCom, journalism, mass communication, rural development, sociology, Sanskrit, which is introduced for the first time this year, Hindi, economics, master in science, cyber security, public administration, and public policy are all very popular. This year we have introduced bachelor degree program, which is in Oriya, political science, history, English, sociology, journalism, bachelor in business administration, BCom, Hindi, and economics. And more than 1,600 students have taken admission in these programs. What is happening to me, and I take pleasure, maximum pleasure out of it, is 80% of the students, exactly 79%, belong to rural areas. So our mandate of reaching out to the unreached, reaching out to the rural people, reaching out to the disadvantaged groups, reaching out to people who are residing in inaccessible area has proved to be successful, because 79% of the students belong to rural area. Around 50% of the students belong to scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, and OBC category, or socially and economically poor sections of the society. That again gives me a lot of satisfaction that an open university has been able to meet the educational aspirations and requirements of students other than the general category in substantial number, that is 50% of SC, ST and OBC. I would also share with you all with a lot of happiness that this year overall admission of female student in terms of percentage is more than the male student. 51% of the students are female and 48% are male, and 1% have shown that they are transgenders or they might not have given the gender in their forms. Similarly, 30% of the students are married students. They have other social commitments, but they want to get higher education. So 30% of the students are married students and 70% are unmarried students, which is again a feature of Open University. Then around 29% of the students are employed or self-employed, which is again a unique feature of Open University. And in terms of medium of study, 50% of the students have opted to study in Oriya medium, because large number of students are in MA Oriya and BA Oriya. That is the reason why it shows 50% of the students have opted Oriya medium and 50% of the students have opted for other medium. Other medium is either Oriya or English, or it is Hindi if it is a course offered in Hindi. But I can assure you that more than 75% of the students other than MA Odia and BA Odia have opted for English medium, which is a quite interesting happening for Odisha Open University. So almost 80% of the students are in bachelor degree and master degree, which is a healthy sign, a good sign for a university which is only 3 years old. And I see you as the champions of the university, as the ambassador of the university, and I assure you the best services that are possible, Odisha State Open University is ready to provide to you. I thank you once again for joining this university, and I request the coordinator and the counselors who are present here to provide the best of services to the students. Thank you very much.